Thank you.
Okay, hi everybody. My name is Noel. I work at Murex. And I would like to talk to you about how we can set up a RPC remote procedure call server for database access. So why do we need such server? Suppose that we want to make an application, which in fact is a search engine for searching real estate announced in the web in a city like Denver. In order to do this application, we will need a web crawler to crawl the web with the real estate announced in the web. Let's say that we do this in Python. We will need a TensorFlow module, so the deep learning framework of Google, and we will use this to recognize similar image between between anions, so that we can catch duplicate anions. Let's say we use the Python API of TensorFlow. We will need a REST server, so let's decide to choose CPP REST SDK in order to handle our REST call from our application. We will need a database, and let's pick one on the cloud. Let's choose DynamoDB, for example, so the NoSQL database of Amazon Web Service. So finally, we will need a database, a way to access to our database from our different services. So now I will just quickly explain how we can set up one. So if you decide to make this library in C++, so we pick DynamoDB, so we will need the library, AWS CPP SDK DynamoDB. Since we need to access to the database from different services and in different programming language, we need an RPC framework here, so Swift will be helpful. So in RPC framework, we need to define in a file the list of functions that the service will provide. This description needs to follow the interface description language syntax. So here is the one of Swift. So we have put function, get function, scan function, remove, and update, create table, and delete table. So once we have defined this file, we will need to run the first command to generate a part of the client and server code. So we will have our function with empty body, and we will need to fill the body of this function. The second command line is to generate a skeleton of the client in Python. So after you have run this command, we will have our RPC server and a client that could communicate. So the main advantages of this approach is that we have a very simple interface. We can decide to change our database vendor, and in this case, we will just have to drop the server and develop a new one, and with very few change in our functional business code. Thanks to Swift, there is a code generation tool. So if you decide to change or to add a new service in JavaScript, for example, we can quickly generate a skeleton of the client. So here is a link to the Python script, so of the TensorFlow module, and I have just extracted the line of code that update the database with the duplicate column. So the interface is quite simple. We passed, so this is in Python, so we pass the table name, the item key of the key in the database, and value is just a map of value with the duplicate column name and the actual announce ID that we want to set in this column. So this is good. I have available on GitHub. Comparison to what you said.